My name is Augie Pullman. Next week, I start fifth grade. And since I've never been to real school before, I'm pretty much totally petrified.
I'll see you later.
Augie, you don't want to walk up with your parents because it's not cool.
But you're cool.
I know I am, but technically most dads aren't. Neither are these helmets.
Dear God, please make them be nice to him.
I've had 27 surgeries. They've helped me to breathe, to see, to hear without a hearing aid, but none of them have made me look ordinary.
Like the character Augie in the movie Wonder, our next guest is starting fifth grade this year. Diagnosed at birth with Apert syndrome, she's undergone nearly two dozen surgeries. Here to share the treatment for this rare syndrome and how their patient blossomed, please welcome pediatric plastic surgeon Dr. Matthew Greives with Children's Memorial Hermann Hospital, along with patient Angeliz and her parents Liz and Jesus. Good morning. All right. There are so many things out there that a lot of us have never heard of, these rare things that kind of happen in the body. So tell us what Apert is.
So Apert syndrome is a condition and occurs in about 1 in 70,000 children, but the bones of their skull, their face, their hands, their feet are fused at birth. And so as they grow and develop, they have no room for any of the structures like their brain or their eyes. They can't use their fingers to pick up things. And so those are all things that we have to surgically treat as the children grow.
Yeah, and Liz and Jesus, is this something you noticed right away? Or when did you know about this?
No, we don't know. When I'm pregnant and they make the ultrasound, we never see if she's born like that.
Yeah, and so you could tell early on though that something was different?
No, we find that actually at birth.
At birth, yeah.
Yeah, it was a bad experience because when she was born, they just took her out of her hands and she was like, there's something wrong with this baby.
Yeah, there was something I knew that you needed to get to right away,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And so, Dr. Apert, obviously when they say bad experience, it's one of those things at first, it's shock when something's just different, right? But the key then is to get the right diagnosis, number one, and then the right help.
Absolutely. I think a lot of parents, we are doing better with getting better ultrasounds, so a lot of parents have a lot more information. But there are cases like Angeliz where we don't know until the children are born, and hopefully they can come to a center like Children's Memorial Hermann where there's specialists and we treat these complex conditions over and over again.
And that's the key. We say it's rare. You got to be with the right doctors right. In the right hospital. All right, so Angeliz, almost 24 surgeries. You know what's so cool about you is that you've gone through all of this, but all the nurses and all the people around you say, this girl, her name Angeliz, Angel, you're an angel. So, what gives you such a happy attitude?
Everything that makes me happy in life, and it always makes me happy. And playing with my brothers.
Yeah, yeah. And what do you have to say to another child out there who's having to face a lot of surgeries and things?
I hope they feel better soon, and I hope that God bless them in every way.
Aww. All right, so. Obviously, this is a complicated situation. It's not you go in for one surgery and then you're done. So tell us what you're doing when you're doing these series of operations. And I would imagine just the fact that you're a growing child impacts that as well.
Right. So, I mean, as a plastic surgeon, we always think that what we're doing is trying to help someone look better. But in this case, and a lot of what we do in pediatrics is trying to give kids the opportunity to grow.
Yeah,
so
function.
We're looking at what the problem is. So in Angeliz's case, she couldn't close her eyes. She couldn't breathe through her nose. She was snoring at night. She couldn't chew her food because her teeth didn't fit together. And so, or her hands, her fingers were fused together. So the surgeries we design are intended to allow her to become more normal and to approach that normal life so she can go back to school, she can be like everybody else in her class, and then just let her personality lead and make friends the good old-fashioned way.
Yeah, we saw that movie clip earlier. And so, Angeliz, how do you deal with kids at school? Or do kids at school treat you nicely? Because if not, I'm showing up.
Yeah. Yeah, kids treat me good at school. They always treat me good at school.
Yeah. So yeah. I heard you have a career that you want to do when you grow up. What do you want to do when you grow up?
A veterinarian, so I can help sick animals and help animals that feel sick and I can make them feel better.
All right. You know, I got to tell you, anytime a child is going through something, and my son's been through his battles, we as parents just want to wrap our arms around them and protect them from the world, right? Yeah. And then we realize that they actually teach us better lessons and bigger lessons than we think we're teaching them. What lessons has Angeliz, with her whole positive attitude, taught you all?
Well, she's give you all kind of lessons, like be brave, be strong, be smile every time. She's our angel.
Yeah.
She's our angel.
And Jesus, as you mentioned earlier, obviously it's scary because you had no idea when she was born, but for a parent who is in that same situation, what do you say to them?
Just take it one day at a time and don't blame it on yourself or your partner. You know, this is a blessing and we are blessed. We won the lottery with Angeliz.
Yeah, yeah. And we're blessed in this community to have doctors like you. There's other things that you work on, you know, cleft lip and palate, congenital facial abnormalities, just osteogenesis, all kinds of things that can happen. As you mentioned, when you're dealing with pediatrics, it's not about aesthetics. It's about function and the whole bit and restoring somebody to like how they can live their life free from a lot of people's other judgments, right?
Right.
So again, the important thing here is that you have doctors who actually specialize in this.
Right, and it's July, so this is the end of National Craniofacial and Cleft Awareness Month, so we're highlighting not only our patients that have these facial differences, but the ability for teams like our team at Children's Memorial to really let these kids get back out there and you know, go to school like everybody else in August. So.
Yeah. All right, Angeliz, what grade are you going to be in?
Sixth grade.
Oh, you're in middle school, are you now?
Yes.
All right. Well, you have a great school year. Thank you all very much for coming on. And, Doctor, thank you very much
course,
as
thanks.
Well.
Thank
and
you.
For more information on plastic and reconstructive surgery at Children's Memorial Hermann Hospital and the Texas Cleft Craniofacial Team at UT Health, call 713-222-CARE. That works out to be 713-222-2273 or visit children's.memorialherman.org.